and gentlemen, it's a pleasure one more time to be with you this morning, praying that God will touch this morning, move in His power and His resurrection might as we are coming to you live this morning, as I am coming to you live this morning. I want to give God thanks for the next Friday morning. Good morning to every one of you. Actually, if you could click share, it would be great this morning as I'm getting ready to pray for you in a little bit. But I just want to speak a word of encouragement over you and encourage you to be still and know that God is God. But I want to talk about the harvest is great this morning, because God have called us in the vineyard to do great work for Him and to go out there and preach the gospel and to touch the world. So we have called for a purpose, and because we are called for a purpose, we must fulfill the mandate that God have gave to us. This morning, harvest is a symbol of gathering. We want to talk about harvest, and nobody can break it down like Jesus. So we gotta go to the Word, because God is the master or the Lord of the harvest. You can't get nothing without God give you. So this morning, I'm going to talk about the harvest is great. And let us read from Luke chapter 10 and 2. Therefore said he unto them, the harvest is truly great, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord of the harvest, that he would send forth laborer into his harvest. Jesus is saying right now, he's talking to the disciple, and he's saying, there is greater work to be done, but the laborer are few. So he's saying, pray that God will actually send folks to labor in his field, because the harvest is ready, but nobody is willing to labor to get the harvest. It's a farmer. You gotta plant a seed to receive a fruit. You gotta plant a seed to receive a tree. You gotta do something. So Jesus said, listen, the harvest is truly great, but the laborer are few. There are folks that don't want to stand and the Word of God. There are folks that don't, good morning, that don't want to preach the Word of God. There are folks that don't want to go out in the field and work, labor. It simply means, the word labor means to toil, to get your hands dirty, to get it filthy, to get it messy. And so when God calls us, He calls us to labor in His harvest. So we're going to get our hands dirty sometime. We're going to get it filthy sometime. Because though the harvest is right, you're going to work with some messy folks, because the labor is not easy. Anybody that I've ever done job that is, it take labor, you understand what you gotta do. You gotta work hard. You gotta get yourself dirty. You gotta get yourself messy. And so Jesus is saying, I call you to go out in my vineyard, and I want you to work out there in my vineyard. Good morning, Sister Richard, Richie, that from England, UK. I think that's your name. God called you to labor, to work out there in the vineyard, to get your hands dirty, to get it messy. You are a laborer in the vineyard for God. And so God called us to do something that is going, because we are dealing with folks now that are actually crackhead, actually lost, junkie. And now you got to labor, you got to deal with them, you got to work with them. And so God called us to labor in his vineyard and to work, because the harvest is ready. The problem with it, God already prepared the harvest. Oh my God. God already prepared the harvest for us. So we don't actually we only got to labor. We didn't plant it. It go back to the promised land. We didn't plant it. We just got to labor. Go out and I will make you fisher of man. You got to labor, ladies and gentlemen. John 4:35 say, not he, there are yet 4 months and then cometh harvest. Behold, I said unto you, lift your eyes and look on the field, for they are white and ready to harvest. God said, behold, Jesus said, behold, look at the harvest. Glory be to God. It's ready to be picked. It's ready for you to reap it. It's ready for you to take over. And he was not just talking about harvest in a field, but he was actually breaking down the kingdom principle. He's saying that if you don't go out there and touch nobody, nobody won't come, because folks are ready to give their lives to God. Because Jesus used everything in a typology, and Jesus is trying to show us something, that there are folks that is actually waiting for you to manifest in the earth realm and to actually demonstrate the power of God, that somebody can come to Jesus. You are the fisherman, and you will have to go out and fish. What do a fisherman do? Do a fisherman sit home and just relax? No, he gotta go out and fish. Jesus said, I'm gonna make you a fisher of man. So you gotta go out there, you gotta fish, ladies and gentlemen. And when you look at it now, ladies and gentlemen, I will be praying in a few minutes, just give me a few minutes. You gotta be fisher of man. So you gotta understand that when Jesus meet Peter, and he said, Peter said, we cast our net all day, God, and we didn't caught no fish. What are you telling us? And God said, go back out, Peter, and cast your net one more time. Go out in the deep. And so many times when we go to work for God, we want to stay at the place that is not deep. Because deep place get us scared. Deep place is taking us out of our realm and putting us in a realm that we don't belong in. But God is saying, is when you step out by faith and go further than what you can imagine, that's when I will back you up. Glory be to God. So Jesus said something now. He said, listen, when you go out to the field, you must understand that you are a preacher. And what a preacher do is actually, they are a fisher of man. Okay? So when you go to the field, you're going to cast some good and some bad in your net, okay? Jesus said now, let both grow together until the harvest, oh yes? And in the time of the harvest, I will say to the reaper, gather ye together first the thorns, okay? And bind them, to burn, okay? But gather the wheat in a bar. So he's saying, listen, gather the wheat together. Gather the wheat together. The wheat is the good, okay? So the wheat is the good, and the tares is the bad. He said, I'm going to separate the good from the bad. You must understand that it's good and bad. When Abram got a seed, the seed was Isaac, Ishmael was the seed of the flesh. Ishmael could not go into the promise because God do not promise flesh nothing. God said, my glory shall manifest in man, but I will not glorify in no flesh. Ishmael believed he was of the flesh. His nature was of the flesh. But Isaac was a spiritual child. And so folks that is of the flesh, they will always try to denounce you, always try to laugh after you, always try to criticize you because they are of the flesh. You are of the spirit. Hallelujah. When you are of the spirit, you are separated. You are set apart. You are sanctified, and you are called to do a great work in the kingdom of God. So I want to remind you this morning that you are called to do great things as great ambassador of the kingdom of God. Proverbs 3:29 said, honor the Lord with thy substance and with the first fruit of all thy increase. It said, honor the Lord with thy substance and with thy first fruit of all thy increase. That means it's not just talking about money. It's not just talking about prosperity. It's talking about everything. You must honor God in a godly way. Reverence him. Reverence him as king. Honor him in your life. Honor him in your workplace, in your environment. Give him the glory and the honor. And the first fruit is not just talking about money. Give him the fruit of the spirit, the praise of the spirit. What I mean by the fruit, I gotta actually correct that, because God, the Holy Ghost, it give us the fruit of the spirit. But what I mean, send up your praise to God, because the spirit give us fruit. And if we stay in the word of God, we will bear more fruit that we can praise God and glorify God. So Proverbs said, give God your first substance. Everything, you must give God the first. Remember, the Lord said, I am the first and the last. Remember, he said that. And he's also said, have no other God before me. Oh yes, he must be the king over your life. He must be the prince over your life. He must be the one that is governed in your life. He must be the first over your life, ladies and gentlemen. And I want to read from Galatians 6:9. And let us not be weary in well doing. Oh yes, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. What the Bible is saying right now, be not weary in well doing. What is well doing? Actually, well doing is the things that you are doing for God. You probably be a missionary in the vineyard. Be not weary, because maybe nobody's following you. You might be helping the homeless shelter out. Be not weary in well doing. You might feeding the homeless. Be not weary in well doing. The Bible's saying, be not weary in well doing. Why? Why must you not be weary in whatever you are doing for God? Because in due season you shall reap. That's the season of God. In due season, God shall give you back everything that the enemy are trying to steal from you, and what God gonna give you double for your trouble. I know that you are going through, but you cannot faint now, because the Bible said, if you faint not in due season, God is gonna make you reap if you faint not. So let us, ladies and gentlemen, work the good work of faith. Let us hold fast to eternal life. Let us hold fast to this eternal salvation that God have gave to us. And let us work in his vineyard and believe God for the supernatural this morning. Ephesians 4 and 28 said, let him that stole and steal no more, but rather let him labor, working with his hands the things which is good, that he may have to give give to him that is needed. So Paul is actually saying, listen, everything that you can put your hands to, you must work. You must work because not only give to the needy in prosperity perspective, but also give to the needy in love and charity. That means we must love, we must cherish others, we must put others before us. We must always seek that somebody is covered. Somebody can. We must care for the widow, care for the homeless, care for those that don't have it. We are called to harvest in the field of God. And I believe that God have called you in an appointed time like this for you to work in his kingdom. It don't matter what come, because the enemy will always fight you, because the enemy don't want you to work. The enemy don't want you to go out in the field and harvest for God. Anything that is about God or it connected with God, the enemy will always fight you, because the enemy don't want to see you go to a next dimension in God. I want to remind you that all of you is going to be blessed. If you believe it or not, you are going to be blessed. If you believe it or not, but can you hold out until your time comes? Because your time is going to come, but you don't know when it's going to be. So can you hold out? Because God is saying, just keep on working in my vineyard, in my harvest. Just keep on laboring, and the day come that you are going to reap. And folks is going to look at you and say, how did you get there? You've been laboring. You've been praying when nobody has been praying. You've been fasting when nobody has been fasting. You've been evangelizing when nobody else is evangelizing. You are studying the word when nobody else want to read the Bible. And so the day come that God going to repay you. And when God repay you, he's going to repay you good. I want to tell you, if you don't get repay in this life, you will receive the crown of salvation, and there will be star in your crown, star of peace, star of work, star of faith, and you will have more crown. And remember that the kingdom of God have position. Some folks is talking about the kingdom of God have no position. That's a lie. Michael got a position. Actually, Lucifer got a position when he was in the kingdom of God. He lead the angel. He was the leader of the choir. He was the one that bring the angel and worship God and present praise and worship before God. So I want to remind you that there is authority and position in the kingdom of God. So ladies and gentlemen, when you work and do the work of God in this life, I want you to know that don't take it for granted, because you are going to be repaid for everything that you've done for God, because nobody ever do nothing for God and don't get repaid. If you ever done anything for God, God will repay you. That's why Isaiah went to Hezekiah and said, Hezekiah, you shall die. And Hezekiah said, no, God, remember the days that I done right in your sight, work and praise you, give to your kingdom, remember God. And God, Hezekiah turned to the wall and cry to God, and God said, I've heard your cry, and I'm going to extend your days because of your cry that you cried to me, and you remind me of the works that you do in my kingdom. There must be something that you can remind God of what you have done for him. There must be something that you can say, God, I preach this gospel all these years. God, I was faithful. I get up and pray. God, I stay in your presence for hours. God, and the doctor tell me that I'm sick. I believe that you still heal. You must can remind God or remember God about bring something to his remembrance. It's not that God don't remember everything. God is eternal. He's everlasting. He know everything. But you can bring it back to his remembrance and say, God, I've been a faithful servant of you. God, you cannot allow your servant to go down like this. And God will just shift the script. And God will just open the door. And God will just shut the door of the enemy. Because God will always hear a servant prayer. Some folks said, you don't go nowhere, and you are not a preacher that travel the world all the time and preach the gospel. You just want to stay one place. Let me tell you something. When you read about Elisha, the Bible said Elisha really didn't go nowhere. Actually, the Bible said Naaman, that was sick with the leprosy, came to Elisha. Elisha didn't even come out of his house. Elisha said, go and dip in the Jordan 7 times, and when you dip, you shall be cleansed. And Naaman got mad and said, how could you not come out to me, Elisha? I'm a king and I'm sick of this. I thought he was going to come out and lay hands on me. The Bible told us that Elisha prior life was closing in. He was closing in his place, and he prayed. He seek God. And you know that Naaman was coming before Naaman reached. Oh yes, that when he reached, hallelujah, ladies and gentlemen, that when he reached, the Bible said, Elisha said, go dip in the Jordan the 7 times, and you shall be cleansed from your leprosy. That means you don't have to be where the person is at. You speak the word, and the word already done it. You don't understand. A prophet got certain realm in the spirit realm where they have a connection with God. That's why when you look at prophet, most of them don't chase down the money. They don't chase down the world. They chase down God because they need God, because they know that people are relying on them, and the world, most of the folks are looking to them, and they want to be connected with God. Any prophet that don't really want to be connected with God is actually a lying prophet. But any real prophet of God, Jeremiah was close to God, Elisha was close to God, and every prophet that I know was close to God. As a matter of fact, let me tell you, Elijah didn't have no friend. Elijah didn't have no friend. His only friend was Elisha. And everywhere Elijah went, Elisha come. And Elisha said, I need a double portion. I'm willing to give up everything to just receive God. Sometimes you gotta be willing to deny some stuff just to receive the glory of God. You know what's wrong with this generation? We want so much fun and we don't want God. That's the thing. And I let me tell you that I'm not saying you must not have fun. I'm not saying you must not go to places. I'm saying that your little fun is going to finish. Fun is a state of mind. If you believe that you're at a place where you're having fun, you can have fun right in your house. It's a state of mind. Some folks believe that they gotta go across the world just to have fun. It's a state of mind. I'm trying to tell you, if you got joy in the Holy Ghost, you will have fun, ladies and gentlemen. You don't have to go to every TV show. You don't have to go to every comedian show. You don't have to go to every event, because the Holy Ghost, ladies and gentlemen, will entertain entertain you. The Holy Ghost will give you entertainment. Oh, Shiba, Mako Sitar. So many folks don't have no relationship with God, so they cannot be entertained by God. If you ever, hallelujah, feel like preaching this morning, if you ever tap into the supernatural, you tap out of the natural realm and you tap in eternity. When I get in the Bible, I'm not just in the natural realm, I'm in eternity. When I'm in eternity, I don't go by time, because there ain't no time in eternity. When I enter my prayer closet and I pray for 2-3 hours straight, I tap in eternity. When I tap in eternity, I don't look at time, because God don't move by time. God moved by his presence and by his spirit. You gotta stay there until God endue you with power from high. Some of us want his presence, but we not willing to spend the time in his presence to receive his presence. You want something from God, but you're not willing to stay there and say, endue me with power, God. Fill me up until I want no more. You gotta willing, ladies and gentlemen, to stay there until something happen. Because if you gonna labor in the harvest, you gotta be willing to go out. And if you're gonna go out, you can't go out in the harvest field that is great without power. Because God called a generation that is a driving force, a moving force, a heavenly force, that when you go out in the vineyard, somebody's life will be transformed. Somebody's life will have a transformation, because you're going with substance. I don't see a generation like this. All we want is just nothing but the world and the pleasure of the world and the fun of the world. Let me tell you, when I choose Jesus, I deny the world and I pick up my cross. I deny a lot of stuff and I pick up my cross. If I did not deny a lot of stuff today, I would not have no power. If I did not deny a lot of stuff, I wouldn't have a prior life. If I did not deny a lot of stuff, I wouldn't seek in God midnight and reading my Bible. I gotta deny some TV. I gotta deny some movie. I gotta deny some friend. I gotta deny some people. Because what I want, you can't give it to me. It's only God can give it to me, because I'm here to change the world. Jesus said, I must work the work of him that sent me. The night cometh when no man can work. Jesus didn't say, I must work part-time. He said, I'm called to do the will of the Father. The will of the Father is full-time. God don't do nothing part-time. He said, I call you to work the work of the Father, because the night have come when no man can work. So what are you doing right now? Are you working? Are you moving? Are you motivating yourself to go to the next dimension and establish the kingdom of God? You're called to for great purpose. You're called to manifest in the earth. You're called to send back demons. You're called to loose those that are bound. You're called to set the captive free. You're called to loose prostitute, loose junkie, loose crackhead, loose the liar, loose the gangbanger, loose the lost and blind nation that don't know God. You ain't called to sit down all day and watch TV all day. You ain't called to sit down all day and play game all day. You are called to do the will of the Father, because the day is coming when you can't do the will no more. I feel the anointing of God. The day is coming when you can't do the will no more, ladies and gentlemen. So we must work the work of the Father. The Father is saying right now, if you step out by faith, don't watch what folks is saying. You're called to go out. You're called to demonstrate his power. You're called to change the world. I don't care if I deny everything in this world once I got Jesus. If I got Jesus, I can deny everything in this world and move on. Because there is a greater in me. I'm telling you, God is the greatest. God is excellent. God is wonderful. And when you find out how loving God is and kind and merciful to you, listen to me, ladies and gentlemen. Some of you should have been dead. Some of you should have been in the grave. Some of you shouldn't be here today. Listen to me. Who grant you life is God. I look at life in a different perspective, because when I look at my life, I should have been gone. So listen, and I couldn't call in nobody else but Jesus. So it's Jesus that redeemed me. And so I came to work for the master. I came to declare the master to the world. And because Jesus has redeemed me, everything must be about Jesus. Hallelujah. Everything must be about him. Everything. So listen, this morning, I want you to encourage yourself. But not only encourage yourself, I want you to deny some stuff. If you can deny some stuff, you can be a great laborer in his harvest. Feel. If you can deny the things of the world. Because I'm not saying you must not have fun. I'm not saying you must not go to place. I'm saying just don't caught up in it too much. But caught up in God. I'm not saying that you can't watch TV. I did not say that. I said just don't caught up in it. You know, folks can sit down 25 hours and watch TV. I mean, I'd rather pray. Because God is a way maker. And so, folks can sit down all day and talk on the phone. I don't have time for that. I don't have time for that. It's more about God. More of him, less of me. This morning, I want to thank you now. I'm going to pray. Give me a minute. My throat is so sore. Alright, so this morning, we're going to pray. Actually, I will give every person some time to call in if you want me to pray for you. Man, we gotta be real. We are going through so much. You know, this morning I get up, and I'm gonna be real with you. When I get up, I can feel like something running in my head. I said that's an attack from hell. I just went in prayer and it leave. The enemy attack you when you don't pray. It's very important. And when you don't cover yourself under the blood. And so many times we get angry and different things upset us and we don't cover ourselves under the blood, and the enemy attack us at night. So make sure you cover yourself under the blood. And this moment I'm giving you the privilege to call in like what I do every morning, or just drop your prayer requests in the comment box, because we're going to pray. So drop your prayer requests in the comment box below. If you cannot call in, if you can't call in, then you just dial that number. It's 646-484-8962. So you can call in and I will pray with you right now. If you going through problem, you know what I actually really want to pray for, as I was talking about the vineyard, is those that I probably do it the next time, but going through a relationship problem. I want to pray for you too, you that are dealing with your kids and they are giving a lot of problem. So this morning, if you want me to pray, please call in and I'll pray for you. You can drop your prayer request. I see you from UK. Alright, you want me to pray for you? Alright, ma'am, I will. Is there a special prayer request this morning that you want me to pray for? If there is a special one, can you please just put it in the comment back, because you are way in the UK and are the United Kingdom and you cannot call. So just drop your prayer request. I know you want me to pray for you, but is there a special prayer request that you want me to put before God? I'm gonna pray for you. Heavenly God, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father God, we ask you this morning, as this woman of God asks you, God, for prayer. We ask you that you cover under the blood. And so we send the blood of Jesus to bind every plan of the enemy. Father God, we pray that you touch her. God, I pray that she will say yes to your will. Yes to your way, God. Open the floodgate of heaven. Pour out a blessing now. Touch her from the crown of her head to the sole of her feet. Dismantle every assignment of hell. And I decree and declare that she is in the right place, the right position for harvest. And I decree and declare your life shall never be the same. In the name of Jesus. Amen. All in, ladies and gentlemen. You want a breakthrough, financial breakthrough. Okay. Farreboshia, I cover your life right now. And I pray that God will grant you a financial breakthrough. He said, God, where one and two are gathered, you are in the midst. So we speak a breakthrough in the atmosphere. And I command your finance to turn around. In Jesus' name, excuse me. In Jesus' name. Call in, ladies and gentlemen. Let me pray for you. If you need me to pray for you right now, the number is 646-484-8962. Dial in. Let me pray. Because I need to get out of here in a few minutes. But I want you to call in if you got a prior request. If you don't, then I will be off in a few minutes. But I believe all of you got one. I believe all of you going through. All of you that been listening to me, thank you. We appreciate it. One more time that you've been listening. I believe that the favor of God is going to rest upon you. And I believe that God is going to break every chain. Sister Jasmine, pray for my children and my grandbabies in this time. Okay. In the name of Jesus, Father God, we lay Sister Jasmine before you. And we ask you, Father, that your eternal power will break every chain. Father God, we cover the babies under the blood and every one of her grandchildren. We decree and declare, Father, that the power of the everlasting Father, Lord God, you will cover under the blood. Bind every power of darkness. Bind every power of darkness. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we pray, God, that you touch now. We pray that you cover from every rapist, every violence, every murderer, every sorcerer, in the name of Jesus. And so we release Sister Jasmine now, Richardson, right now, God, under the blood, Ikoshiba, and we cover her children, and we ask you now, Father, that you grant her the mercy and the grace. Cover her children now from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. Release them by your angelic being of heaven. And we thank you that your power is great, is wonderful, is marvelous. Send down your power. If you got a prior request today, dial the number, call in. We are praying for you right now. In the name of Jesus, I don't care what the enemy told you. You ain't dying. You ain't going homeless. You ain't gonna run out of money. You are a child of the King. You are royal. You are holy. You are what God say you are. You are a chosen generation. You are a royal priesthood. You are peculiar. Glory be to God. You are moving in the power of God. You call to manifest the glory of God in this time. I want to tell you that the enemy don't have no power over you. The enemy is defeated. The enemy cannot conquer you. The enemy don't have the power to conquer you. You got power over the enemy. This morning I want to tell you, whatever tried to defeat you, it will not defeat you. Because there is power in the blood of Jesus to cancel, to bind, to break in the name of Jesus. Alright, I'm going to pray now, and if you need prayer, you can call in, but it's almost time for me to get out of here now. I'm going to pray, believe in God for the supernatural and the miracle and His miraculous power to touch you. I want to pray for all of you this morning that actually going through financial difficulty. I want to pray for all of you this morning that fighting just to make it. Fighting just to make it. God said the harvest is right, ready. Not just the harvest of laboring in His vineyard, but the harvest of for you to reap. You can't stay at the same place. You was called to manifest. You was called to go to another dimension. Let's pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you for your power today, God. And so as we come before your throne, we ask you, God, that everyone that are going through financial difficulty right now, we pray that you will open the door, God, and every enemy door that the enemy have closed in the name of Jesus. We command it to be opened by your blood. Father God, we trust in you, our refuge and our very present help in the time of trouble. God, we lift you up in this time, oh God. You are the God of heaven, the thousand camel, and the hill belong to you, mighty God, this morning. And so many of your people, oh God, is going through financial difficulty, mighty God. But I pray this morning that you open the door, Father. Oh God, I pray that you touch with your anointing. I pray, God, that you break the chain of darkness this morning. Send your blood, oh God, to cover them. Oh God, send a raven like Elijah. Oh God, to feed your people in the time of trouble. Father God, I pray that your power, oh God, be released over them this morning. Oh God, over their mind this morning, Father. Over their soul this morning, Father. I come against the plan of the enemy. I come against every sickness, God. I come against every evil force this morning. Oh God, that come to bind them up spiritually, mentally, mighty God, emotionally. I pray this morning, Father, that your power, God, will flow. Oh God, through their body this morning. I pray, God, that your power, God, will break down the wall of wickedness this morning. Father God, as we come before your throne, we know that you're the great I am, God. We know that you're the lily of the valley. We know that you're the rose of Sharon, God. We know that you're the ancient of days this morning. And so, Father God, there is nothing too hard. Oh God, so many folks are going through, oh God, so much stuff in life this morning. But I pray, Father God, that you strengthen them. Oh God, strengthen the young man, God. Strengthen the whole man this morning, God. Let me see your glory and your presence this morning. Father God, cover those in the highway. Oh God, those in the byway this morning. Oh God, that is going to their job this morning. Father God, I pray for those that don't, God, have a job this morning, Father. You will provide for them, Jesus Christ. Make a way out of no way, God. I pray, mighty God, for those that are depressed this morning, God, and the enemy come to depress them. Father God, so much stuff going on in the land of America, mighty God.
Father God, I pray for immigration this morning. Those immigrant, mighty God, that are going through so much stuff, mighty God, this morning. Oh God, I pray that don't want to leave their family. Oh God, that politician, God, is oppressing them this morning. I pray, oh God, for the church, mighty God, those that don't have no paper this morning. Oh God, that you will cover them under the blood. Father God, I pray that you seal them with your blood, mighty God. I pray, mighty God, when every immigration officer come after them, God, oh God, they would be blind by the angel of the Lord. Mighty God, I pray for those that are worrying this morning, mighty God, those that, mighty God, are burning down by the problem of life this morning. Father, I pray, God, that you grant them mercy this morning. Oh God, I pray that you cover them, God, under your blood one more time, Jesus Christ. Father God, release their mind this morning. Release their soul, mighty God, from every power of darkness this morning. Father God, I pray this morning, God, that you send your angel to guard them, God. I pray, mighty God, that you send your angel to protect them this morning. Father God, send down your power in a mighty long way. Oh God, to wash and to cleanse this morning. Father God, to pure this morning. Oh God, move in your power, Jesus Christ. Move in your resurrection glory this morning. Father God, as we come before you, we release our anointing in the atmosphere. Oh God, anointing to break the barrier of wickedness, mighty God. Anointing, mighty God, to pull down, rip down every plan of the adversary this morning. Oh God, Satan, mighty God, that is a roaring lion this morning, Father, seeking who he might devour. But I pray this morning, Father God, that the enemy will not devour the children of God this morning. Father God, I pray that you touch the weary heart this morning, God. I pray that you touch those, God, that feel like they can't make it. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Father God, pour out your anointing. Father God, pour out your blessing upon them this morning. Oh God, I pray, God, that they renew their strength in a time like this. Father God, I pray that you strengthen them, mighty God, from the crown of their head, Jesus, to the sole of their feet, mighty God. I pray, God, that you anchor them in this time. Oh God, I pray that you wrap them up in your blood. I pray, God, that if evil foes that come against them this morning, oh God, they will scatter 10 way by your blood this morning, God. I pray, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, touch them this morning, Father. Touch their life this morning, Father. Touch your soul this morning, Father. Touch their mind this morning, Father. Touch your heart this morning, Father. Touch your life this morning, Father. Touch your finance this morning, Father. Touch them one more time, God. Touch them with your power, God. Touch them with your glory, oh God. Touch them with your move, oh God. Touch them with your spirit, oh God. Break up the fallow ground of the enemy this morning, God. By the blood of Jesus Christ, I command you to arise and shine, because the glory of the Lord is here, and the spirit of the Lord shall arise and shine in you this morning. By the power of God this morning, I cancel every attack of darkness this morning. I cancel every evil in high places. I bind every warfare that come against your life this morning. I send the thunderbolt from heaven to strike the four corner of the foundation of the earth, to destroy and devour every plan of the enemy this morning. I send the power of God to scatter the plan of the wicked this morning, mighty God. I send the power of God to touch your broken body, heal you from every disease, heal you from every infirmity, heal you from every pestilence, in the name of Jesus Christ. I send the power to break, I send the power to bind, I send the power to paralyze, I send the power to trample down, I send the fire of God like a thunder this morning to come cover you on the highway, on the byway, mighty God. Those that are in Jamaica, I pray for them this morning, God, that you cover them on the highway, the byway, mighty God. I cover the pastor, mighty God, under the blood, mighty God. I pray for Pastor Green this morning, Pastor McCoy, mighty God. Put Helder Scott under the blood, Father God, in Jamaica, Father God, I pray for this pastor, Father God, that it will not be devoured by the plan of the enemy, God, in a time like this, Father God. I pray for those, mighty God, every saint, mighty God, in the highlands of Jamaica, God, that you cover them under the blood this morning, renew their strength, mighty God. I cover those, mighty God, that are in the UK right now, I send the blood with fire, oh God, to cover them, God. I command the blood this morning to pull down, tear down, rip down every stronghold. I command the blood this morning to cover you this morning, Father God, send the blood over Nigeria, mighty God, over Africa, mighty God, and I cover Africa this morning, under your blood, mighty God. I send the blood this morning, over the 52 state, God, of America this morning, God. I send the blood to Barbados, I send the blood to Trinidad, I send the blood to Antigua, I send the blood this morning, God, over all the Caribbean, mighty God. I send the blood, mighty God, to Grenada, I send the blood to Guyana, Father God, in the name of Jesus, I send your blood this morning, over every Caribbean country, Father God, the Republican, mighty God, this morning, I send your blood, mighty God, over Puerto Rico this morning, I send your blood, mighty God, with fire, mighty God, let your blood cover, God, let your blood sanctify, let your blood break down, God, every barrier of wickedness this morning, Father God. I release your mind with the blood, I release your spirit with the blood, I send the blood of Jesus, hallelujah, the blood of Jesus, set it over, the blood of Jesus, I send it over the school bus this morning, Father God, cover every school bus, Father God, cover every school under the blood, I pray this morning, mighty God, no spirit, mighty God, no radical Muslim spirit, no ISIS spirit this morning, I send the blood against it, in the name of Jesus Christ, I bind every rapist spirit, in the name of Jesus Christ, I send the blood of Jesus, hallelujah, to cancel every assignment. The blood, I send the blood of Jesus. The blood in your house, the blood over your furniture, the blood over your car. I cancel every assignment by the blood. I break it by the blood this morning. I pull it back by the blood this morning. I send the blood to your body this morning to heal every infirmity. The blood of Jesus. Can you feel it? The blood still work, the blood still got power. They come, Mashiach. Rutoko subo, mako shito rebam sute, eko suta, rutoko shimato, eko site ko shibeko, rebam sutoko sute. The blood of Jesus cover you, the blood cover you, hallelujah, and the blood cover you, eko shima, the blood cover you, wekama sute, the blood cover you this morning. I send the blood over you, the blood, I send the blood. You need the blood covering this morning. Every car accident is canceled. Every accident is canceled. Every attack is canceled. Every demonic forces trying to attack you this morning is canceled. Cover yourself under the blood. Believe God that you're covered. Hey God, you're covered under the blood. Somebody said you don't have to use the blood. Yes, you got to use the blood. The blood is so powerful. It can heal you from mental sickness. The blood is so powerful.
It can heal you from infirmity. The blood cover your house. The blood watch over you. I feel that God is covering you under the blood. Believe it. Receive it. You are blood cover, blood sanctify, blood born again, blood believer, blood glorify, blood wash. What kind of blood? Jesus' blood. So no weapon that form against you this morning shall prosper. Clap your hands. Give God the praise for the cancellation of the assignment. I just believe that you need to be covered this morning. Some of you are going on the road to run taxi, to drive, to do delivery, and to do all kind of stuff. You need the blood. You need the blood. Oh, the blood prevail. Hallelujah. God cover you this morning under the blood. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Father, bless them now. Keep them in perfect peace. Let their mind stay in you. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. God cover you. Sorry. God bless you. God cover you under the blood. And keep yourself encouraged in the word of God. So much stuff is going on. You need somebody to pray for you and cover you. That you can be protected in a time like this. God know that you need to be covered. So much is going on. But the blood will never lose its power from day to day. So cover yourself under the blood. Believe that the blood will work. And the blood will cover you. All of you that are in Jamaica, I just need you to cover yourself under the blood. Every one of you that are in Jamaica, cover yourself under the blood. If you cover yourself as I'm speaking right now, no rapist, no murderer, no perversion shall come beside you. The blood is powerful more than any spirit that is trying to molest you, trying to overpower you. Nobody understand. I'm going to tell you what happened. When a rapist come, if you got the blood and the impartation of the Spirit of God, the spirit will make they start to shake. Everyone that come to attack you, they just going to start to shake and fell to their knees. Receive that word. Believe that word. Everyone that come to attack you, they just going to start to shake and fell on their knees. Believe that word. Receive that word. Everyone that come to attack you, I don't care who it is, they going to shake and they going to fall on their knees. Because you got the presence of God with you. You are blood cover, blood bought, blood sanctified, Holy Ghost filled. Hekoshiba. And so the blood is covering you this morning. I want to pray one more time. I just feel it. Somebody came on late. And I just want to ask the Father to cover you all that are in the island of Jamaica from every extortionist, every drugs lord, every murderer, every rapist, and I cover you under the blood. America, I cover you under the blood too. But I want you to believe today that the presence of God, Hekoshiba, Matokosai, is walking with you from today. You are not alone. You are not alone. God is walking with you. You will see things in the spirit realm that don't look normal. And sometimes you will see shadow passing you. Is a sign that God will be walking with you. Some of you will start to get dream and vision and all kind of stuff. God is going to open your eyes and reveal things to you in this time. You need this. You need this more than anything now. This is the great season for you to walk in the prophetic and receive an impartation of the prophetic. What do you mean? Let me show you something. Elisha said, I need an impartation. He got the mantle of Elijah, and anything that Elijah did, glory be to God. Elisha did it. So the prophetic is actually, and I'm supposed to get off, but God had me talking the same way, is an impartation. So right now, I'm imparting something in you. Right now, the prophetic is going to keep you. So when you go into a problem, you just got to say, God, remember the God of Sheldon. Glory be to God. Remember, Elisha said, I come in the God. Elijah said, I come in the God of Elijah. Elisha said it. Elisha is the one that was following Elijah. Okay? Their name is so close. But Elisha said, I come in the name of the God of Elijah. Hekoshiba. That means you can come in the name of somebody that trusts in the real God. My name is not. It's for people that don't really have a connection with God. You can go in the name of Jesus if you got a connection, because that's his name. You can't cast out no demons in my name. I don't have no authority. But you can believe the God of Sheldon to heal you. Because Jesus said, whatever you do it in my name, whatever you do in deeds or works, do it in my name. But if you believe in the God of Sheldon, because I believe in the God of Abraham, you can be blessed. Ke Hamashia Reba Shuta. So, I want to tell you that once you believe in the God that I believe in, and I believe in Jesus, you actually can be blessed. Because when you face the mountain, and you don't know what to say, and you rebuke the mountain, and the mountain don't move, you said, I come in the God of Sheldon. That means it's Jesus. The prophetic will release right away. And once the prophetic release, it will break the bar of wickedness. Elisha came in the spirit of Elijah. Do you know you can receive somebody's spirit, but you can't receive the anointing that they got? Heko Shaba. The spirit of the Lord is upon me. That's what Jesus said. Heka Shaba. That means God's spirit was upon Jesus. So this morning, I want to tell you that you are walking in the supernatural. Not only that you are walking in the supernatural now, you got an impartation from the man of God. So this morning, every one of you that's sick, lift your hands up. You're going to be healed from your sickness. You're going to be healed from your sickness. Lift your hands up. Father, Ikan Sheba, in the name of Jesus, I send divine healing and impartation of the prophetic. Release it. Receive it. You are healed. You are healed. You are delivered. If you believe it, you can receive it. If you don't believe it, you can't receive it. God want to bless you. God bless you this morning. I believe that you are called in time like this to receive somebody right now. Kaylin, Kaylin, K-E-L-L-Y. I want to pray for you. Right now, your life, as I'm looking in the spirit, And I'm looking in the spirit right now. And you are going through ups and downs. Sometimes you walk in the spirit of confusion. And it seems like nothing is moving in your life. But as I speak the prophetic word over your life, there will be a change and a transformation in your life. I want you to know that the enemy been oppressing you, because from the foundation of time, you was predestinated in the plan of God. And so the enemy is trying to oppress you, and it seems like every time you receive a little money, you lose it. And it seems like everybody is against you. And I want to tell you that the enemy has set out an assignment to break your back and to pull you down. And I want to remind you after today that assignment will be canceled. And you shall have a transformation. I believe that in this season, this time, God will grant you the request for you to receive a job opportunity. And I want you to believe God that in this season, your season will be changed from not just enough, but more than enough. Because you've been into a place for a long while where you just have just enough to survive. But I decree and declare after today, there will be a turnaround in your life. I give you 24 hours to give me a testimony that there is a turnaround in your life. As I'm speaking to you, I can feel the prophetic of God. And God said, get ready. He's going to dry your tears and he's going to give you double for your trouble. Every tears that you cry, this is the season for a change in your life. And this is a divine impartation. Connection is not just a regular connection. You've been seeking for knowledge and wisdom. And God said, in this time and this season, I will open your knowledge and your wisdom, and I will give you insight of my word. And everything that you've been through a lot when you've been young. You've been through a lot. You've been talk about people like abuse you. You've been through a lot when you're young. God said right now he's breaking that spirit of abuse off you, and he's breaking up the fallow ground and release that tears, because he's going to heal you from every infirmity. God said, know that I am the Lord and I will keep you in perfect peace, and know that your mind must be stay on me. You are going through a lot of stuff where you're going back and forth, and it seems like you don't know where your life is going. But I tell you that after today, your life will change. And I want to prophesy to you that your life shall never be the same, cannot be the same, because God is going to move you to another dimension. Lift your hands up and believe God for the supernatural. I decree and declare that every stomach pain that you got, it shall dry up and it shall be removed. Everything that the enemy is trying to attack you, and the enemy trying to put sickness in your body, I feel the anointing of God. And the enemy trying to put sickness in your body, but I heard the Spirit of the Lord said, in this season, I'm touching you and I'm giving you a divine healing and impartation by my Spirit, said the Lord. Raise your hands, child, and believe God for the supernatural. I decree and declare that your stars shall shift in the heaven, and you shall think different, because there is a demonic forces that afflict you and trying to stop you. From going where you want to go. There is a spirit that assigned to your life for you not to be successful, for you not to go to nowhere in life. But I decree and declare that you gonna be released by the power of God. This ain't no guess. This ain't no fake prophet. This is real. I decree and declare by the word of God that you going to be released. So lift your hands and believe God. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I decree and declare by the power of the supernatural, I command that your daughter right now, for you to release her right now. Every spirit that hold her hostage, in the name of Jesus, and leech that spirit from him. Open the door and release her destiny.
destiny. Release our future. Release her in the spirit realm. I command you, Satan, to take your hands off her in the name of Jesus. And I speak divine partition of healing, of move, of breakthrough in your body in the name of Jesus. Receive, receive, receive. Ekashiba. Receive, Imasuta. I decree that you shall not beg bread. Your children shall not beg bread. After today, there will be no more bread begging. The devil is a liar. There must be a change. You will have favor with man and favor with God. And I decree and declare that you got a calling in your life. It's time for you to give your life to God. If you don't give your life yet, it's time for you to surrender and say, give me your will. And God is going to set you up and put you on a platform. Hallelujah. Great. Hallelujah. God is mighty. He's everlasting. I feel the power of God. Anybody this morning, God is still a healer. God bless you. You are set up for a miracle. Thank you, Jacqueline, for your donation. God, we appreciate it. Thank you for your gift towards the man of God. I appreciate it. I just can't give you thanks enough. And I won't deny it, and I will speak it in the atmosphere, and God shall bless you double for every trouble that you've been through. God shall bless you double. Thank you, Sister Jacqueline. God bless you. God bless you. May the grace of God be with you, rest upon you. Until next time, be under the blood, cover under the blood, and God love you. You are a chosen generation. May the grace of God be with you. Have a great day. Some of you going to work. Some of you ain't. Some of you don't have no job. I pray that you get a job. In the name of Jesus, God bless you. God bless you. Amen.